Welcome to example program. In this video, we will see how we can write a Java program to check for the largest number among the three numbers by using the ternary operator. I have already made a tutorial where I have explained the same program by using the if-else conditional statement. So in this tutorial, we will be using the ternary operator. This ternary operator is a conditional operator which allows you to check for a condition, and if that condition is evaluated to true, then you can execute some code, and if the condition is false, then you can execute some other code. To use this ternary operator, first we have something called as the conditional expression. We write this conditional expression using the variables and all the operators available in the language, and this conditional expression is evaluated. If this conditional expression is true, then true value expression is executed. If this conditional expression is evaluated to false, then false value expression is executed. So here we will have the colon, and it will be the semicolon here in the end. Here what happens is we will have an expression in this conditional expression part. It is executed. If it is evaluated to true, then true value expression part will be executed. If this conditional expression is evaluated to false, then false value expression part will be executed. If you want, you can nest the ternary operator in this true value expression part or in this false value expression part. If you want, you can use ternary operators again. So in this video, we will be nesting them, and you will learn more about that when we do that. So now let us see how we can use this and write the program to check for the largest number among the three numbers. In this tutorial, what we're gonna do is we're gonna store three values in three different variables. For example, let's say n1, n2, and n3. Let's say we have 15 here in n1 and 22 in this n2 and 45 in this n3. Here we have to find out the largest value. So what we do is we check whether the n1 variable is containing a value greater than n2 variable, and n1 variable is containing a value greater than n3 variable. If this is true, then it means that the largest number is present in the n1 variable. If n1 is not containing the largest value, then we will check whether the n2 variable is containing the largest value. And for that, we will check whether n2 variable is containing a value greater than n1, and n2 variable is containing a value greater than n3 variable. If it is so, then the largest value is present in the n2 variable. If both n1 and n2 variables are not containing the largest value, then it means that the n3 variable is containing the largest value. Okay, so here we will be using this logic and we will be writing the program. So let us see how we can implement this in a Java program. Here I have written some Java code. I have created the package example program, and then I have the class program. And then I have written the public static void main method, which is going to be the entry point of our program from our perspective. Now in this program, first let us declare the variables where we are going to store the values. And I'm going to take integer types of variables. So I'm going to declare them as integer, int. And then I'm going to call my first variable as n1, second variable as n2, and my third variable as n3. Okay. Now the next thing that we can do is we can ask the user to enter the numbers, and we can store them in n1, n2 and n3 variables. In this tutorial, I'm not gonna do that. I want you to implement that part of taking the user input and storing them in these three variables. Now here, I'm gonna specify the values directly. I'm gonna store the values directly here. For example, 22, and similarly 66, and let us say 25. Okay, now we have three variables containing three different values. So we need another variable to store the largest value that we are going to find out, and I'm gonna call that variable as largest. Okay, now we will use the ternary operator and we will find out the largest value. So first what we do is we will check whether this n1 variable is containing the largest value. And we can check for that by writing the condition n1 greater than n2 and n1 greater than n3. Whether this n1 variable is containing a value greater than n2 variable and n1 variable is containing the value greater than n3 variable. If this condition is true, then it means that the largest value is present in the n1 variable. So I'm gonna write n1 here. What if this condition is false? For that, we will write some other code in this false expression part. Now here, I'm gonna use a pair of parentheses and I'm gonna close it here like this using the semicolon. Now here, this is the conditional expression part. If this is evaluated to true, then this will be executed, n1, which will return the n1 variable's value. And if this expression is evaluated to false, which means that n1 variable is not containing the largest value, then this part will be executed, which is for the false value expression part. Here, within this parenthesis, we will write the statement for the false value expression. If the n1 variable is not containing the largest value, that is, if this expression is evaluated to false, then we will check whether n2 variable is containing the largest value. And for that also, we will use the ternary operator and we will write the condition as n2 variable containing a value greater than n1 variable and n2 variable containing a value greater than n3 variable. If it is so, then the largest value is present in the n2 variable. If this is false, then what we want to do? Here, this part is executed only if this expression is evaluated to false. In this program, it means that if n1 variable is not containing the largest value, then only this part will be executed. So here, we are checking whether n2 variable is containing the largest value. If it is so, then we say n2 variable is containing the largest value. If n2 variable is also not containing the largest value, then it means that the n3 variable contains the largest value. Okay. Now this will give us the largest value and we will store that in this largest variable. Okay. So here we are nesting the ternary operator. As a whole, this is one ternary operator. This is the conditional expression part. This is the true value expression part. And this is the false value expression part. In this false value expression part, we have again used the ternary operator. This is the conditional expression part, true value expression part, and false value expression part. For some of you guys, it may confuse, but if you understand the working of the ternary operator, then you will get it. Now we have the largest value. The next thing that we do is we will print out the largest value. So I'm going to use the system.out.printf function. And here I'm going to format it like largest among %d%d and %d is %d. Okay. Now here we will say largest among n1, n2 and n3 variables value is largest. Okay. So we are just filling out these placeholders with these variables values. Okay. Let's build and run this. Largest among 22, 66 and 25 is 66. Now if I change this value to 202 and if I run it again, now you guys can see largest among 202, 66 and 25 is 202. Now here we are using the ternary operator to write this program. I have already made another tutorial where I have explained the same program using the if else conditional statement. If you like this video, then hit the like button. If you don't like it, then hit the dislike button. If you want to say something, then write that in the comment box. For more tutorials like this, do subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next video.